good indicator that we can use that the whales are about to come crashing through the surface is the frequency of the feeding call will start to sweep up in scale. It's really distinctive and it kind of gets the tension building. It's super cool.
Some herring sounds coming in. Pretty cool. Hey, there's feeding call. Got feeding call.
Watch for bubbles.
Sweet. Yeah. Bubble net.
Got it.
11 o'clock. Sweet. Nice.
Got it.
Nice.
Start to finish.
Excellent.
Sort of what got me into this whole game was dropping a hydrophone and hearing these amazing sounds flowing up through the Alaskan wilderness. And I just like, I don't know what that is, but that is so beautiful and so amazing. It's like, okay, I'm hooked. We spend a lot of time out on the water with these magnificent beings. We use a variety of tools, sonar, hydrophone, video cameras, and just a lot of time being in their presence and carefully studying their behaviors. Well, there's probably as many reasons why whales launch themselves into the air as there are whales. Most of the time, we can't seem to figure out exactly why they're doing it. I think one of the most remarkable things that we're finding about these whales is how incredibly human-like they are. They form these remarkable teams, and they form enduring bonds that can last years, decades, perhaps even lifetimes. And that's a remarkably human thing, and I think more than anything, just developing a deep sense of appreciation for these animals is what's going to help both humans and humpback coexist on this planet.